Hey, Glenn and Amy with a Cactus Atlas here. We are in Phoenix, Arizona today at the Phoenix Zoo for the 2020 edition of ZooLights. We want to take you along with us, but this is the first time Amy and I have ever visited this, ever. So you're going to see our first impressions of this, and it's been a long time coming, so we're just going to jump right on in. Before we start tonight's adventure, I want to give you a heads up. This video is going to feature a lot of flashing Christmas lights. So if you have photosensitivity issues, you might want to proceed with caution. You can kind of see the line here to get an idea of the crowd tonight. I would say this is probably a light night based on some evidence I've seen in the past. Right off the bat, look at that. That is absolutely beautiful. I am entering through the gateway into ZooLights 2020 officially. I'm assuming this is the official entryway after you scan your tickets, of course. Yeah. So shortly after you enter, you're greeted by beautiful Christmas lights everywhere. This is just getting started, and it's already blowing my mind. So yeah, as I mentioned, Amy and I have never been to ZooLights before. We attempted one time, I think, with my family, maybe a few years ago, and we weren't able to find a parking spot. It gets that crowded. So we've come out here the week before Thanksgiving, or the weekend. It's a Saturday before Thanksgiving break, hoping it's a little less crowded. There are a lot of people here, but I don't think it's as crowded as it normally gets. It's just a hunch. I could be wrong, but so far it seems very manageable. So what exactly is ZooLights? Well, duh, I mean, you could probably see. We're not here to see animal exhibits or anything. We're here to see Christmas lights exhibits in the zoo. They actually have a drive-through event also this year because of the pandemic. I don't know if we're gonna make it out to the drive-through event, but we're doing the on-foot event. You wanna check their calendar because they alternate nights. Some nights are drive-through only and some are walk-through only. You don't get both in the same night. So think about what you want, check the calendar, and I would try to recommend getting out here earlier than later because of crowds probably. So here in this courtyard, they've got choices of like stuff, hot beverages, I think hot cocoa, coffee, kettle corn I smell. So they have some good yummy treats here. Not sure, I just had a coffee, so not sure if we're gonna get anything, but we might as the evening goes on. Just wanted to let you know they got stuff here. You know, this isn't even the main event, and I'm just transfixed by all these beautiful lights. I can already tell you they did a bang-up job with the lights here, so I haven't even seen the best things yet, I know it. We're just scratching the surface, but this is really cool already, loving it. Just in case you're wondering, the carousel is closed for ZooLights. Womp womp. Makes sense though, I think. You know, we're here, like I said, the week before Thanksgiving, the Saturday before Thanksgiving, and I needed some Christmas cheer early this year, and that's why we're bringing this to you guys now. 2020, my goodness. Oh my goodness, look at that. Look at the reflections on the water. Just look behind me, look at the reflections off the water. I mean, that's like a work of art in a way. Absolutely gorgeous. All the lights turned off and something's happening. Ooh, synchronized light show. Yeah! So they made an announcement about some kind of synchronized light show, and I think this is it. Hopefully we don't get copyright violations from YouTube for this. One of the things that I love, they have high top tables like this and benches all over the place. So you could just sit, relax, and enjoy that beautiful view. Look at that. It's the SRP tree. SRP is the Salt River Project. It's an electric company, a utility company here in Phoenix. I see an elephant, a lion, and a lot of lights. I believe the elephant exhibit is over here to the left, actually. So that would make sense. It's a baby elephant. Is it Dumbo? Couldn't be. The ears are way too small. Ooh, it almost looked Halloween-y for a moment, but that's red. Saw the spider web. Amy and I were excited, saying, ooh, is it a Halloween section? I mean, it could be. We can make it into
that.
It's purple, so it's close enough.
And a spider web.
Yeah, I'm assuming there's an insect house somewhere around here, and that's why they did that, but I'll just...
It looks like Halloween. It makes me happy.
It does. We'll leave it at that. I think I won the race. What do you guys think? Did I beat the cricket? I did have my camera on me and a camera bag and other stuff, so I was at a disadvantage. I think he may have beat me just by a smidge. I want to make a note. I do think the quantity of light so far is far greater than I thought. I didn't really have anything to base expectations off of. My gut said, it'll be pretty cool, but didn't realize like how jam-packed the zoo is with lights. I thought it would be like a smaller section, but so far it's literally the whole zoo. That may change, but we'll see. Look at all these twinkly lights up there. Wow, that is beautiful. That is absolutely beautiful. Oh my God, it is a gigantic elephant's butt right in front of me. Steer clear, folks. Watch where you step. Everybody's so busy looking at the Christmas lights that they passed up the fact that there's an elephant, I believe, feeding right here.
Spoiler alert, that's not what I'm smelling right now.
And hope you enjoy your visit. Stay safe, everyone.
So there you have it. I guess there are some cameo appearances from animals here during this event. Bonus. Look at the moths or butterflies. I'm assuming butterflies up there in that tree off in the distance. I'm assuming we are entering flamingo territory now because I see a bunch of pink flamingos all over here. Ooh, a multicolored tree. A lot of families here, and a lot of people that are here on date night, I can tell. A lot of folks holding the hands, getting into the holiday spirit. Loving life here. I see turtles now, and on this side, I guess more turtles, I'm gonna guess. So right behind me is the Galapagos tortoise exhibit. What's the plural of tortoise? I think it's tortoises, right? Not tortoise? I don't know. Amy and I just realized something. This like little path we're walking on was the same route we drove through the zoo earlier this summer in something called Cruise the Zoo. I'm gonna assume probably the same route likely that you would do for the ZooLights drive-through. But if you wanna see a video about Cruise the Zoo, we'll put a link in the description down below. You should check it out, it was really cool. When do you get to drive through a zoo?
We found Santa's workshop, it looks like, but I don't see Santa anywhere.
For those of you that might be out in Anaheim, California, if you're looking for Harold the Yeti, telling ya, he's here in Phoenix. Vacationing for the winter. He's a snowbird, I think. I have a feeling we've got a long way to go, but Amy, what are your thoughts so far?
I love this.
Yeah, me too. This is so much better than I thought it could ever be. I mean, by a magnitude of like 100.
It makes me want to go home and watch Christmas movies.
Yeah, me too. So, I tell you what we can do for you. We're going to put some information on our website, cactusatlas.com. If you're interested in coming here, link in the description below. And we'll try to help you get started on your planning for this. Look, it's Bigfoot. Bigfoot is here at the zoo. I knew it. So you got to see Harold the Yeti and Bigfoot in one night. When does that happen? Is that a velociraptor? Some kind of dinosaur. For those of you hankering for a camel ride when you come here to ZooLights, they got you covered. So we're heading towards something called the Wildlife Lantern Safari. Sounds intriguing. So it looks like these are like kind of glowing displays here instead of Christmas lights. They're actually really pretty right off the bat. There's more of them down that other way. Now that's what I'm talking about. We need that on our front lawn. We have to outdo all the neighbors this year. And that right there would do it. These lanterns are among my favorite things I've seen this evening, I think. Snow leopards? Which I don't think they have actual snow leopards here at the zoo. Nor do they have woolly mammoths last time I checked. What in the heck are these? I was gonna say a turkey at first, then I was thinking goose. It looks like a goose turkey. Goose turkey, I like that. What's your guys' vote? This looks like the under the sea portion. I see jellyfish, I see starfish, seahorses. So we're about to go underwater, folks. It's a hammerhead shark and killer whales. Ooh, looks like a squid. Not a giant squid, just a little one. It's all right. This one threw me off at first. It just looked like a tangle of lights to me. And Amy aptly pointed out, I think it's an octopus. I'm really quite enjoying the C-section also. It's just got a pretty chilled out vibe, I'd say. Ooh, lemurs. Lemurs are cool. I think we've re-entered the glowing lantern section again. It was kind of broken up by some cool lights, the under the sea section. Some more cool lanterns to check out though. That's one of the more vibrant things we've seen this evening. Reminds me of Las Vegas. There's some platypus. What are these? Some kind of I have no idea. Koalas. Or giant rats. You decide. Ooh, look at this. There's a teddy bear driving this old fire truck. That's a classic one too. Engine 72. Amy was saying the same thing I was just thinking. We really like these purple and orange light combos. Kind of Halloween-y. You can see they're doing another light show right now. I'm gonna guess every 10-15 minutes. I haven't timed it, I don't know, I've not read about that, but it's constant. So that's heading back towards that initial lake that we saw. Quite possibly our favorite spot. I'm gonna guess that these are the Arizona creatures representing a mountain lion, maybe. I'm gonna guess a roadrunner. And that green blob over there, I have no idea. And here we have bighorn sheep. You'll actually see some of those at the Grand Canyon, believe it or not. And certainly in other places in Nevada, I've seen plenty of these guys, like Valley of Fire State Park. You know what, I'll put a link in the description down below. Go check out my Valley of Fire content. Some of my favorite stuff. Some more phenomenal Christmas lights all over. I see some really fast moving lights up there. This is a rattlesnake, I think. All right, this one is pretty cool. I like this one a lot. We've got a lot of rattlesnakes in Arizona in the Southwest, so this guy's representing. Amy thinks that's an alien back there. I'm not so sure. Ooh, flamingos. And these folks are having a grand old time here. Oh, dude, Amy just spotted the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man, I think. Awesome!
What does the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man have to do with Christmas? He looks angry and... Okay, and we have an electricity-wielding wizard, a unicorn. And a scarecrow?
All right, they started another synchronized show. We're not really in an opportune spot for it, but once you hear that like heavy metal Christmas music starting, you know stuff's about to get real. Okay, Amy thought that was the Angel of Death, the Grim Reaper. I think it's some kind of a wizard. Amy thinks it's a death wizard is her latest, but I think it's just like, what I see is like a wizard like with magic coming out of his hands, holding a wand to like a torch or something.
But doesn't the face look like a skull?
I can see your point about it looking like a skull, but...
Is that just me being Halloween obsessed?
I think so.
All right.
This section is known as the Arizona Trail, kind of near the beginning, and it's a one-way loop. So that way they're kind of enforcing a unidirectional flow through this section. I like that. Oh, sweet. Look behind that giraffe and you see Saguaro dressed up like candy canes, I assume, and a screaming child. Yeah, this is a really cool tree, red, white, and blue. It's either a patriotic display or one of those like frozen ice cream icicle things that were the red, white, and blue ones. You guys remember those? That reminds me of that for some reason. Oh, this is really cool. I have not seen this kind of display anywhere else in the zoo yet. That's a little trippy, I would say. This is a nice vantage point to see the loop through here. This whole center section is filled to the brim with light displays, and I think we're about to wrap our way back around, back to the beginning here. Wow, just look at that, that's beautiful. I think I see a mountain lion stalking its prey back here, look at that. And that's some animal's buttocks. Oh, it's a rhino. They even have two-headed birds here. They thought of everything. You know, there's just something magical about the reflection of the lights off the water on that lake. Yeah, I mean, Amy and I think are both in agreement. Yeah, this center part is the best part. It's hard to choose a good part though. This has just all been over the top awesome. Okay, so I think that's gonna wrap up our first experience here at ZooLights at the Phoenix Zoo. Yeah, I mean, Amy and I just kept saying wow the entire time. You've seen it for yourself. You can decide if this is something that would interest you. This is a tradition, like I said, absolutely every year. We will be back. Blew our minds. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe. And find us on social media at Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.